The Police are number one this date in 1983 with Every Breath You Take. 1992 is next.
This is Radio 2 on BBC Sounds.
And on your smart speaker.
Play BBC Radio 2.
BBC News at 2 o'clock. This is Harvey Cook. In the past half hour, Surrey police have said they've arrested a man for running onto the course at the Epsom Derby. The horse race took place without disruption, despite warnings from animal rights activists that they would try to delay it. 19 people suspected of planning to cause disruption were arrested earlier. The BBC's John Hunt watched as the winner crossed the line.
King of Steel hits the front, chased by one of the favourites, August Rodin. King of Steel, August Rodin, though, is moving to top gear. They have come about 8 lengths clear of White Birch, staying on in third. What a battle to the line! August Rodin just getting on top. August Rodin won the derby for Aidan O'Brien and rider Ryan Moore.
The Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, has arrived at the scene of a train crash that killed more than 260 people. The three-train pile-up in the eastern state of Odisha has been described as one of the deadliest rail disasters in decades. About 1,000 people have been injured. The head of the local fire service, Sudhanshu Sarang, has been leading rescue operations.
We managed to remove all the injured to the hospitals for medical care. Then we had to account for the fatalities. Some of the injured are quite seriously ill.
Police in Warwickshire say a woman in her 70s has died following a dog attack in Bedworth. A man and a woman have been arrested on suspicion of owning a dangerously out-of-control dog and possessing a banned breed. Israel's army says a member of the Egyptian security forces has killed 3 Israeli soldiers near the border between the two countries. 2 of the soldiers were found dead early this morning. Israeli forces then searched the area and had an exchange of fire with a suspected gunman, in which he and a 3rd Israeli soldier were killed. Britain's rail network has been disrupted by another day of strike action. Drivers belonging to the Aslef Union have walked out in a long-running dispute about pay. Elaine Wrigley runs a bar under a railway arch in Manchester, and commuters make up a significant portion of her customers. She says she's losing money every time there's a rail strike.
It's really hard to really guess what it's going to be like on the days of the strikes. It massively has impacted our breakfast and morning trade on the days the trains are on strike with workers not coming in to the city. So we have our team members at work, but not necessarily any customers for them to serve. So it has a massive impact on our cost base.
Despite the train strikes, 90,000 fans are expected to watch the Manchester Derby FA Cup final at Wembley starting in the next hour. Manchester City, who've already won the Premier League and face Inter Milan in the Champions League final next week, need to win today to keep alive their hopes of the treble. And that's the BBC News at 2:03.
Traffic with Sally.
Thank you, Paul. Starting on the A628, still very busy westbound as you head along the A57 at Mottram Moor, and that goes into the M67, which is also very slow. That queue in town seems to be affecting the A57 northbound as you come away from Glossop up through towards Gun Inn. There was a problem, I think it was a car fire earlier, thanks James for this, on the M62 westbound between 25 and 24 coming down from Hartshead Moor. It's all been cleared away, but it's still with a last looked, it was still very slow on the approaches. Now on the M1, we had 2 lanes closed earlier, northbound between 34 and 35, through the Rotherham area, really, and it's all been cleared away, but it has been very slow on that northbound side of the M1, heading around Tinsley Viaduct. A50, really slow and congested both ways through the Blythe Bridge area, south of Stoke-on-Trent. There are roadworks there, and it's been really busy for most of the time, today that is. Today also there's this big cup final, as you've just heard on the news, at Wembley, so all the roads in the area are currently looking very slow and congested. On the M25 there's one lane shut anti-clockwise, 25 through to 24 through the Waltham Abbey area. The last time I checked the queue was about 4 or 5 miles long, and the M20 in Kent has been completely closed westbound due to an accident between junctions 9 and 8 Ashford and Leeds Castle. 03700 100 200 is the number. More in an hour.
Across the nation, BBC Radio 2. Pick up the pops.
The 3rd of June, 1992, Wilson Phillips down 1-20, You Won't See Me Cry, and down 7-19, hang on in there, baby.
You know,